Welcome to I Heart Reviewing Stuff. So I'm gonna unbox the last girl in series 4 Na-Na-Na surprise. So there's where to look for what number. Crazy that they're already on series 4 because I don't think these have even been around all that long yet. So we always collect the girls. So like series 1 we skipped the tiger guy. Series 2 we skipped the boy that was a dog. And series 3, there was a bunny. And this series, there is a boy who is like a bull. And he's got like a basketball outfit. So there are, I don't think we did any videos for these. So that's why I figured I can do the last girl. This one took the longest to try to get. I originally ordered her on Amazon and she had like a really late in stock date, and then it moved up and then it went back down. So I ended up like canceling it and was just like, I'll just get it when I get it. And it was funny, Marissa and I went to Target on Sunday and we totally saw these at Target. So beware, you might be able to find them at Target. And of course we saw this flower sticker. This is Melody Maud. She's like the more purple-ish bunny. And of course they had it, but I was like, I already ordered it off of Walmart. Because there was another item that went in stock, but I needed to get my total to like $35 so I could get free shipping. Because shipping, like, it usually is like $5.99, and to me, I don't know, I feel like that I don't want to spend $6 on shipping unless, like, I have to. Like, or I don't mind if I'm getting stuff on sale or on clearance, if there's shipping, or, you know, if it's a website that just doesn't even offer free shipping, things like that. So anyway, let me try to get in here. I'm not going to do the confetti. We've done it lots of times, and it just makes a mess. Ooh, I think I let her do the confetti for the panda. Ooh, so I think the panda is Marissa's current favorite. I really like the tiger girl, I think, in this series. But I'm excited for this one, too, Melanie Maud. Ooh, so just be careful when you unbox these. This one is really coming apart and kind of sharp. It's like cracking and stuff on me, so you have to be careful. To me, they could do without this crazy packaging that they put these in. I'm not a big fan. I think this is just like a cutting hazard. The plastic is just too thick for little ones. So just always be careful with that. And then you just recycle this. So it's just waste. It's not like it's anything you can keep. So to me, I don't know. I would rather they just charge like $10 and let us just see everything. I don't really need this whole blind bags thing that they do. Ooh, yeah, so this definitely seems purple to me. And she's got like a more white daisy. I forget what her palm, I think her palm doesn't have a green flower. I think it's a different color, maybe like pink. And then I think there's two blind bags on here. I'll show the checklist real quick because I haven't done a video before. I think I've probably already shown the checklist on Instagram. I don't know if I bothered though, because you can go find this info on their website. So there's the bull, Tommy Turo. So that's the sticker to look for on his. And Bianca Bengal is the, like, tiger paw print. Bebe Groovy has the peace symbol. Julie Joyful has, like, some bamboo. Melanie Maud had the flower. And the kitty sticker is for Paula Perfect. Hopefully, I know a lot of people, we were talking on Instagram that we're kind of hoping like that they kind of start thinking outside the box a little more with these, because we feel like we get like a lot of cats and a lot of bunnies. I mean, even the jumbo ones, that's what they picked. They did a rainbow kitty and then they did Alex Hart, the like black bunny one. I mean, we got a panda and we got a white tiger, but I mean, they had already done a boy tiger, but it is kind of cool. I know some people are excited for the girl tiger that she'll like match the boy. So let's see here. Okay, here's her outfit. And I heard this is kind of like pretty short, Ooh, yeah, that does. Yeah, this looks like a shirt size. I mean, I don't know. We'll see what it's like on the not doll. I've already gotten a heads up seeing unboxings. But I like the boots. Ooh, wow. I forgot about the silver zipper going up the boot. So it's got little flower designs on these black boots. They even have a little bit of heel to them. So those are cool. So always just, I think, the two blind bags, your outfit's in one, your shoes are in one. Okay, and then they're always in this like clamshell, and a lot of people have talked about how, you know, you can never get the doll back in this little palm that they give. It's like a one time of releasing her. It can be a little hard, oof, to get out. I'm trying So yeah, they come in this thing that has some tape. And I think it's like kind of closed as well. And then these do zip up. So cute. We keep them even though I don't really have a use for them. Like it's a cute idea, but I've got like, I don't know, 20 of these maybe now. Because let me think, we always collect the girls. There's always six, and so we always have five, and there's four series. So yeah, this is number 20. This, for that. So I don't know if they really need to continue those or not. So it's like, how many do you really need? And like, I don't know. I've been trying to think of maybe like some kind of fun idea to do with them, but I don't know. I'm just drawing a blank. I know Chad Allen, I think he said his mom put rice in them and uses it as like a chair for her dolls. So I like her hair a lot. She does have the straight hair, which some people aren't a fan of this kind of hair, because they feel like they don't give as much. And sometimes I guess people have had shedding issues with the ones like this. So just be aware of that. And then I know the large ones, I didn't play around with it as much, but I've seen other unboxings where the large ones do have more like wire in their limbs, so they're more posable. I just haven't gotten around to really checking that out. So she always has the little tag, which you can see. We actually remove ours. Marissa asked me to, and I would rather remove it safely than have her yank it off. So this is Melanie Maud, birthday March 10th. This bunny is far out. So, yeah, I removed them just because, I mean, Marissa, I had to change most of these back into their original outfits for the video because, like, she's always changing their outfits. And just a heads up, if your kiddo likes to do that a lot, I have to do things like put the hair like in a ponytail or braids or pigtails. I don't think I've messed with those two yet, but I'm gonna need to do something or the hair is gonna get kind of, the hair can get stuck in these arms pretty easily. Even can kind of get stuck up in here in the neck. So just be aware if your kid likes to change them a lot, you might wanna get one of those little hair ties and like put it in a ponytail or like pigtails or braid it, you know, just so it doesn't get too tangled up. But yeah, here's trying to show like a close-up of the hair. It does kind of look like black hair with blue to me. So she kind of gives me like the downtown OMG vibes with the hair that they did. And to me, like it's, I think there's plenty of it for me. I'm not really seeing shedding happening because it doesn't really need to be brushed. It's soft. And it doesn't seem like too thin to me, but I know some people have issue with that. So let me try to put her dress on and then we can wrap this up. So, and these are easy for Marissa to dress, which is why I think she plays with them so much. Ooh, yeah. Okay, I see what people were talking about with this being very short of a dress. Let me just line the Velcro up as good as I can. Ooh, goodness. Okay. Yikes. All right, I'm pulling it down a little bit before I show. But yeah, they should have gave this a little more length. And let's see. Okay, the left. Okay, so the zippers go on the inside for this one. A lot of times zippers go like on the outside, but for this, they have a left and a right, and this is the left. So yeah, that's how short it is. See how much leg is showing? And I mean, this is the front of her underwear. I just barely feel like she's like right there where her underwear is. So, you know, they, I think, like, make the dress down to here if I had my way. Like, this is kind of her knees, I think. But even just giving it, like, that much more would have been nice. Because, yeah, this, I knew, I had already seen reviews where people were talking about, like, I feel like they gave a little more length back here. I think she's covered her butt pretty good. Her butt's up here. And I feel like I have enough fabric, but for some reason the dress is kind of shorter in the front. So I'm not a big fan of how short that is, because let's compare to this one. See, I know her boots are a little taller, but I feel like they gave a little more fabric for the other bunny. And then, I mean, definitely the tiger, I feel like it's a sweater dress and she's well covered, or it could be pajamas. And then definitely the panda, and then hers is a top and skirt. So yeah, they just could have gave a little more length to that, is all I'm saying. So there they all are for series 4, Na-Na-Na surprise dolls. So these are the newest ones. I think there's more to come, though. I think Secret Crush has a lot more in the works. I saw something about pets, I think. I don't know. There's always a lot of stuff on Instagram, and it's always hard to know, like, what's really going to happen and stuff like that. You always take it with kind of a grain of salt of whether you're going to get those things or not. But I really like the large ones because of the rooted hair and the removable hat and the extra fashions. I just don't like the price point. And even these, I mean, this is $100 right here just to have 5 dolls. I think it's a little too high. I think they could figure out a way to make these just be $9.99. It's what I feel like if they did away with this balloon with the confetti and the blind bags. Like, they could just package it already dressed like this, and then you could see your doll and make sure that there's no defects, you know, before you buy it. I think would be cool. So that's just my opinion, though. I know everybody's, some people might be new to the surprise thing, and maybe they are really into it. And then, like, I don't know. I feel like I've seen it for several years now and kind of ready for something else. So thanks for watching. Bye.